Oh. Oh, dear Lord. Okay, I don't care what anyone tells you. You cannot have a Long Island iced tea without sour mix. Also, spring and buy some actual Coca-Cola instead of Big K-Cola. Oh, I'm gonna throw up on camera for the first time. Anyway, I'm gonna be doing my favorite book. Well, I'm gonna do all the books that I own, because I don't have that many, because reading's for nerds. Okay, let's start with the bookshelf, which is the DVD shelf. First up, I've shown this off in a couple of videos, but that's the basically Lovecraft. I'm a Lovecraft nerd. Pretty good. This one's done by Ballatine Book. Pretty good compilation of all the good stuff. Doesn't have Reanimator in it, which I don't think Herbert West Reanimator has been printed in the book. Probably have to find the old magazines or find it somewhere online when they printed it out.
Bad boy.
This is the most expensive thing I've got on that DVD shelf, and it's not even a DVD. That is the Gospel of Filth Bible Edition. Yep. This is pretty much a chronicling of horror and metal history. And it was written by Gavin Bradley and Danny Filth from Cradle of Filth. Cradle of Filth. And yeah, this is the Bible Edition. It's bound in leather. It's got a little tassel. And it's signed and numbered by Gavin Bradley and Phil. Got a few really cool excerpts from horror icons and from metal icons. And there's no way, I haven't read all this. Corey's read more of it than I have, and I own it. But it's still very valuable to me. I had to pre-order it to get the special Bible edition. And it cost me like 60 euros, which back then was like $110. That's how much I love Cradle of Filth. And most of it's got some really cool pictures from horror movies and bands and shit, but there's one picture that threw my shit off. Like, at first glance, I was like, oh, well, that's a shitty looking mask. Then I read the caption, it's like Ed Gein's actual dead skin mask, and I was like, bah! I had to do a Hank Hill, and I went, bah! But yeah, pretty cool. Leather bound. Yeah, not your number. This is like my horror movie vibe. Got a lot of really good stuff on Clive Barker's work and the classic Hammer films because they're British.
Alright,
I'm gonna walk up to that book. Pretty sweet. Same X I forgot from this. My birthday. Pro graphic novel. Love the movie. Love the comic. Pretty cool stuff.
Here we go.
American Psycho. This is probably my favorite book of all time. I've read this book like 4 times and I hate reading. Good old transgressive fiction. Oh, here's a fun one. Brocabulary. Let me read you some definition for vocabulary. Les dispenser. The dude who turns women into lesbians, usually via melanation. His last three girlfriends ended up hating men and dating women. He's a total les dispenser. Let's find another random one. Rampage. A rampage brought on by PMS cramps. Yo, let's get some Bruce Knight. Need to get out of the house because my girl's on a crampage. Vocabulary. Book of Five Rings. Don't judge me. I am a total nerd for Japanese culture. I got a hard-on for it. My friend mentioned the other day, it's probably because my dad used to teach karate, and that's how I grew up. But don't get any ideas about picking a fight with me, because I don't know karate. I'll lose. I'll cry and shit my pants, and it'll just be a bad day for everyone. Okay.
Lastly,
I hate myself and I want to die. the 50 most depressing songs of all time. This is a really fun read, especially...
Oh! Hello.
Hastings gift card fell out. So it's got the back scratched off, so I guess I'll use it.
Yeah.
50 greatest, or 50 most depressing songs of all time. Pretty cool stuff. Not really cool, but pretty funny if you ask me. Well, those are all the books I own. Get back to this fucking... It kind of tastes like... I'm getting like a corn taste, but I don't know why. Definitely corn. Everything. Bye.